Hey kids, this is Kalir.
This is Pete.
Hey, it's me, Fanboy Master.
Oh man, I love Fanboy Master. I'm so glad you're here.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do, man.
You hate everything.
That is true. They're not making you different. Shut up, man. Whatever.
Alright, I'm
best to say.
So, how to put this? Oh yeah, I spoke to Kalir a little bit ago, like literally minute ago, and decided that we're just gonna sort of just charge the final boss area.
Sick ninja jumps.
You got the teachings of Life Blade, right?
What is that?
This is gonna be awkward if he doesn't.
That's okay. I think you can still do this area if he doesn't.
Yeah, I got that.
Alright, we're good then.
For me, who has only watched half of these, what is this?
This is the story. It's a Metroidvania.
I wasn't talking about the game. I was talking about Teachings of Life Blade.
Oh, it's
a thing that you need to fight bosses.
It's a book that actually lets you damage the bad bosses. So,
yep.
Full disclosure, Kalir was talking about bonus bosses. I was saying, the deal from whatever. But I actually did already kill two of them, maybe even three of them, on my private file that you don't get to see. That I will just allude
secret
to.
Secret.
It's great. The secret file, you can make any, like,
I can make
ridiculous
any claims
you want to.
I can make any claims I want about it on there. But, you all have no choice but to believe them. Unless you've played the game
yourself.
You unlock
yourself. Knuckles on the secret profile. Finally, Valdestoria Knuckles.
Oh, God. I think, the canon explanation for why Knuckles' story and Sonic's story totally don't line up is that Knuckles' story supposedly takes place after Sonic's story.
It does.
And Knuckles is doing is just doing cleanup work on all the crap.
He's not even fighting Robotnik. He's fighting a robot that's dressed like Robotnik.
Hey Jay Bear, what's up?
I like the explanation where probably just one of them remembered it wrong and they're trying to brag to each other about it.
It's Knuckles. Knuckles would be the one who's bragging about it. Knuckles is famously an idiot.
It's like Sonic, you don't chuckle.
Yeah, Knuckles is like famously an idiot who thinks he's a smart person.
And Sonic is just like nodding and being like, yeah, okay, sure, that's cool, buddy.
I could just see him just sort of like going, uh-huh. Yeah, whatever.
Sonic 3 and Knuckles in the Knuckles game does actually have some really nice like background details that allude to the idea that's taking place afterwards.
Yeah.
Like Angel Island Zone is clearly flying.
Yeah, there are nice touches. It is a game full of nice touches. I like Sonic 3 and Knuckles. It is one of my favorites ever.
Okay, do we know where we're going here?
Vaguely. Go into the library, to go into the doorway, to go into the place, to not fall down this time. And if I fall... Wow. Zero damage every single time. That's awesome. Is that from my,
you take a look at your mana bar?
Yeah. Oh, right, yeah.
Your armor's doing that.
Is that my... Which armor? Is that the super armor I'm wearing?
The armor of the Grey Knight, yeah.
The kick-ass Grey Knight armor, yeah.
Meanwhile, the Necromancer Lexicon is saying that you don't freeze anymore, which is nice.
Now I'm wondering something strictly academic that, Kalir might be able to answer.
Sure.
When the game, grades you down during, a boss fight for getting hit, is it grading you down for taking damage, or is just getting hit the part that it grades you down
for? I think it's just getting hit. The instances of damage don't matter that much, so if you're getting hit with this armor on, then it should still take it down. We're gonna fight at least one boss coming up, so we'll get a chance to see it.
We're gonna fight a few if I remember rightly. But no, it does grade you down. Here's a dumb thing. Your combat score gives you a combat score. The way the combat score works is weird and arbitrary, and I don't think I actually understand it. Oh, hey, Farron. Farron can join us too if he wants. He was on one of these.
Alright, I'll go at him. Just see if he responds or not. Ding.
Ding. It doesn't grade you on how much damage you do. It grades you on how many hits you do. So,
too strong could be a problem.
Well, exactly. So, on my other file, I am insanely strong. It's horrible.
I lift so hard.
I am so fucking powerful. Hey, Heron, did you join? I think Heron joined. Or maybe he didn't.
Yeah, we'll see if he does.
Alright, either way. So, So I found myself having to use my terrible magic attacks, which had no like power on them, just to like rack up a bunch of like garbage hits on the boss, just so I wouldn't kill it too quickly.
Right.
So I could
have to throw icicles.
Yeah.
It's the only way to do it.
Okay, cool. So where am I now?
It's officially a stylish action game.
Yeah, no, I ain't going.
So stylish with all the anime glares.
Styling. Hey, Aaron, what's good? Okay,
hey,
this is Sanctuary.
This is not the version of the Legend of Wyatt Earp that I was familiar with.
Wait, what's this? Who's this? I sense my blood in you, warrior. Bring the teachings of life blade to me, and I shall reveal to you its secrets. I have it.
With my bro.
You're ready to learn my ultimate technique? Use it wisely, turning the blade against yourself. Learn from this finisher, life blade. What's that do?
It's a focus finisher that uses your health bar to determine how much damage you deal. Like, this is the ghost of Moira Goibniu, who is the person who fought off the two goddesses and be like, no, screw you, you don't get the soul of all this. But you should just use a finisher that bases off of strength or agility instead.
Let's see, my strength is 20, that's pretty okay. I hope. Strength-based skill. Sure, Rage Slam. That's fine.
Slam the Rage. Hello.
Oh, hey, what are you doing here, dude? What are you doing here? Is he just following me?
Oh, yeah, because this is you attacking, like, the final area, trying to get to the Soul of Valdis, so you'll have, the other playable characters will just be in here for certain screens.
Just chilling,
yeah. You know, hanging out is cool. Oh, hey, I remember you! I fucking hate you! What are you doing here?
Use a Ponce!
Oh yeah, Rookjaw shows up another time, because I don't know.
Because the game hates you.
Yeah, no, that's exactly why. That sounds completely legit.
The game is like, you don't hate yourself enough for playing an Animu character? You know what, I'm gonna punish you some more, just to rub it in.
I mean, at this point, like, you're far, far stronger when you...
Oh yeah, no, at this point, like, he's not even a speed bump. Like, I am... I'm just murdering him. It's kind of gross, honestly. Like, he's already dead.
Bye.
Brutality.
Okay, cool. Who's in here? That's some jerks.
Yeah. I don't know how familiar you are with this game, Heron, but he's basically kitted out his character for ridiculously high bleed damage. So he just hits them once, and then they take like several thousand damage over the space of a couple seconds.
Yeah, basically.
Okay, so bleed, dot, and run away, because sadism.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Basically, yeah.
Hemophilia build.
Bleed stats are legit in Dark Souls. This is Dark Souls, right?
Yes, this is Dark Souls.
No.
This is the Dark Souls of anime.
Yes. Wait, no, I thought Dark Souls was the Dark Souls of anime. I'm confused now.
No, anime is the Dark Souls of animation. It all loops back into itself and that we've all been punishing.
Damn, Vestibio.
Things.
Okay, here we go. This seems like a cutscene.
Oh, it's time to fight Anemone.
Oh no!
Seriously? Like a sea cucumber?
I don't know. That's their
another
name.
Another one has come for the soul of the mother. A feral that can talk. Mother has commanded the guardians to eat demons and angels, but this one is different. May I eat
this one
too,
the model mother? Ship, the baby.
Not baby. It's not baby.
The baby.
The soul of
the
Alice, do you know where it is? The mother is silent. That means I can eat you. You will taste good.
Oh no. You're gonna get eated.
No, I'm not.
This seems oddly reminiscent of Wild Arms and creepy.
But
alright, where
are
we at?
Go away. I don't like you.
So yeah, keep an eye on his combat
score.
Oh,
I found it. I gotta smack his cool rock.
Wait a second. I think I saw you. Actually took a hit from an icicle, and that didn't immediately decrement your combat score.
Yeah. Well, now my combat score's gone to hell. Wait, where the crap? Oh man, there's another one.
Make them bleed!
Okay,
yeah.
What even do I gotta do? This is lame. I don't know what I need to do.
Okay, well, there's the mana heater at the top of the room you can charge.
Yeah, I did that, and I smashed. Oh, hey, they're back.
Yeah. Basically, whenever they cocoon up, they'll summon a whole bunch of enemies, and you have to kill all of them before they can come out and be damaged again. They can still be healed by the healing crystals around, because that's reasonable.
Rip and tear.
Tear your guts. You're huge. You must have huge guts.
V, you really need to stream New Doom. I need that. I need this in my life. It's got skeletons that shoot rockets out of it.
I've heard good things. I want to play it, but I know for a fact my computer couldn't handle it, so I'd have to stream it with my PS4. Which would be fine.
I just don't have it. I'd love to try it, but
it's a great game. It's a video game that's actually narrative at the same time. It's just this really weird balance between the two, and it works for some reason.
So it's just, you're making it sound kind of like Bastion, but way, way angrier.
Doom Guy is just as bored of Doom's story as you are.
You know, here's the thing.
New Doom is
it's the Doom. The way I described it was, you know, it took them way too long to make Doom 3, but the 15 years of wait was worth it.
Ah,
that's pretty high praise.
That is pretty high praise.
Okay, oh, Doom 64 is canon.
It summons fire sirens.
Doom 64 isn't canon, oh my god.
Doom 64 is canon.
No, it takes place in the same universe as Castlevania 64.
Castlemania.
Yes, it's Castlevania 64.
I'm not doing well on this boss at all, so I'm gonna switch this out for a light spell and get myself a boost. Where'd she go? Where is she? Oh god, it's you! It's you! I missed you! Oh, right. Duh. Forgot. What? What? Hi.
Oh, your Grace of Light heals for 46. That's ridiculous.
The interrupts, like when I'm, when she's just like, haha, I'm going into hiding now. I'm gonna hide in my hidey hole.
Yeah,
come on, fight me.
I could have gone without that.
Fight me.
Fight me. Fight me, IRL.
Viking me.
You.
Travel with me to Valhalla.
Okay, there you are.
Boss, oh, hey, she died because I had her bleeding blood.
Yep.
She ran up a little bit. Let's see, I got A rank, and that's HP plus 20. What would an S rank be?
Like HP plus 40, I wouldn't bother.
I don't give a crap about that. HP plus 40, that I know.
Close to the end. We can do this.
Kill things now.
Oh, goddess grave. Oh my.
Grave or
that's a cool skeleton lady. You've come a long way, kiddo. Valdis, you're alive? I am, but only barely. I shall not live much longer. You were the voice that spoke to me when I fell from this place. You shielded me from the fall, and presumably everybody else that fell, since, you know, everybody fell. Like, probably. You're not special, Wyatt. Yes, I also protected
cool
you all
goddess
from the fall. Okay, I called it. But I am responsible for causing it. I hated your fucking boat. Your boat sucks.
You're not my real mom!
I could not keep my daughters at bay for much longer. I was fortunate that you came close enough to the city for me to sense your presence. I've been waiting for you, or should I say, waiting for your dad. My dad? What about my dad? I do not know where your dad is. I sent him to the city to return something to me. Your soul signature is similar to his. You know, like, does this god aware that humans, like, max out around 90 years?
Kind of an upper bound on it.
How old does she think your dad is? I mistook you. Oh, okay, so she thought you were your dad. Gross.
Immortals kind of have a different sense of time than we do.
What is he bringing to you? He was returning my daughter to me. Reyna! Reyna? What? Yeah, that's right. I'm your mom.
Your dad, Stanley.
Mom, you say? How about
push me to expect me to care for the world in my stead? They have no concept of the struggle of the world, some plot shit. Tyrant gods, I did not grant power, only potential. trusted your safe needs to one named Abaddon. Hey, we stole a word from the Bible. I can't even. I'm not even trying anymore.
It's biblical illusion.
Son of Peter.
Do
you remember what we spoke of earlier? Yeah, I remember. Nothing changed. I continue to kill everybody like a sociopath. So you didn't even feel like stopping to morality. Wow, this is not a good.
I
god.
Am here. What?
Traditionally, Gorbanu women were warriors, and men created weapons and armor for them to wield.
But men were men, and women were bimbos.
Actually, it's the other way around.
When men were bimbos, then women were men and manly.
Yeah, basically.
Yep. I'm okay with this. Actually, you know, bimbo is actually the masculine form. It's bimba is the feminine form.
I'm not even going to justify that with a response. You're born to protect Reyna. If any means necessary, and you will kill anyone who threatens the hope for humanity, including humans. So, you know, murder humans to save humans. That works. Reyna's predisposition to light was only natural due to where she was raised, so you must be her darkness. Wait, am I dating Reyna? Like, is that, like, canon?
I don't think so. I don't think that Wyatt, like, has any interest in a relationship that's not
like,
involved
Wyatt
murdering.
Maintaining a relationship?
I could see, like Reyna going, honey, I'm home! And Wyatt just sort of grimaces at her.
That's not a relationship.
Did anyone follow you? Do I need to kill
what
someone?
What about your soul? Isn't that what Magro and Aftermath were after? Soul,
what about your dark
soul?
I like your demon soul. I like souls.
After I die. Above this place, there's a way out. You will know what to do. You need to go to the moon.
You know what to do. Eat more souls.
Okay, I guess we... Wait, this way? I think it's this way. Something tells me it's this way.
Oh, you need an escape sequence now?
Yeah, we got an escape sequence. Oh crap, that's a timer. Didn't even realize
it. It is.
No! No!
Oh?
No! Escaped side timer sequences! This is just like one of my Super Metroids!
The escape sequence itself isn't that bad, honestly. Like, it's right after a boss, sure,
but... I just
but...
got lost and fell back down to the bottom. Like an idiot.
Oops.
Oops, clumsy me.
Oh no, it's a hole.
It's a hole in the ground.
Yep. Okay, but it's cool. It's cool. We probably can make it in 75 seconds, maybe. Hopefully.
Maybe.
Dream.
Again, this is one where I adjust the time you have based on the difficulty. I'm not exactly sure to what degree, though.
Well, we will hope and pray that 61 seconds is enough. Because, yeah, who am I kidding? We're screwed.
That's not a good
thing. Do the best you can with what you got.
Also, it kind of sucks that, like, all those cool people we met are gonna die, like, horrifically.
Oh yeah, you went to all the trouble to save all those towns, but, the barrier's falling.
Oh, what? No, that is
how
bullshit.
Many endings does this
that
have?
Is bullshit. I am sorry. Get better respawn. Okay, good.
I didn't have many endings. Like, basically you get scenes during the credits about whether you've done certain things or not.
That's just a bunch of variants.
Oh, what the hell? Okay.
I wish my pets would stop trying to destroy the house. That'd be nice.
Your pets are nice and cool.
Cosmos part of the difficulty.
Yeah. Cosmos. It's the Cosmos level difficulty. What?
Yes!
Oh, hey! We are all looking at a... Is that supposed to be Wyatt on the far left?
It's an accidental crisis.
Oh my god, his face. Like, I thought the face we were looking at the whole game was something else, but that's something else. The Mana Crystal!
Looking forward to it.
Oh my god!
Oh my...
We just all saw it.
I told
that's
you.
A really abrupt ending?
Oh, this isn't the ending. Why would you think that? You're a silly person.
I guess it looks kind of indie-ish. And, I mean, with an underbite like that, that's pretty...
I can accept this as the ending. And in older versions, this was the ending.
What?
You juked us, Kalir! It's all your fault!
It's not linked to a barrier or anywhere. I can feel it reaching out to something. You gotta be kidding me. What is that?
And all the enemy manga said, do it now.
Well, here it is. So help me take it out.
Hard.
Okay, time to fight
Welcome
a boss.
Welcome to die.
Oh my. Get ready. Do I even hit? Oh, you hit the tentacles. Okay, cool.
Yep. Get the tentacles so you can make platforms to reach the head. This is, boss was actually added in the newer versions. You just go from this storybook style scene to the next one that happens after you defeat the boss, and that was the end of the game. I wish they left it that way. This boss is very tedious.
Oh boy.
There's no rewards for ranking it, of course, because it's the final boss.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, it's still grading, but it seems like it'd be pointless.
It matters if you're running for score on Goibniu mode. Don't play Goibniu mode, though.
Goibniu mode is one save. You can't... you have one chance. If you die, it's roguelike mode, right?
I was just going to say, it's roguelike mode.
Yeah.
It's rogue mode.
You can't save. You have a limited number of heals at the prayer statues. And there's also a timer, apparently. Like, Mogu had to connect.
I get it. I gotta smack the balls, and they go up to her head and explode.
You gotta Ganondorf it.
That is
You gotta Shovel Knight it.
Defeat balls.
No, if it was Shovel Knighting, it'd actually be fun, because then you'd be like, oh, I'm way up here hitting you in the head with my giant sword, but no, now all of the stats he has invested into bleeding do not matter.
Yeah, no, like, all my stats I invested into anything don't matter.
It could be worse. It could be Dungeons of Dreadmore, where you have to have one specific build to be able to beat the final boss.
How long is this gonna take?
This is going
to take a very long time. Like, I'm already exhausted any difficulty from it.
Mate, is at least cool music with Aladdin chorus playing?
Kinda. But, like, you know.
It's not the best music.
I can't really hear it over the mashing of my buttons.
I can't hear it over my rage.
Okay, come on, maybe hopefully I can. But yeah, no,
this
I am
is ridiculous.
I had her down to I had her down pretty low on health. I had her the shield down pretty low, and now I gotta do this bit again.
Yep.
This looks hideous.
Oh yeah, no, this is. It's like you said. This game is a good person who made bad decisions. It was changed by circumstances.
Pretty much.
Shapes are made.
Yep.
Oh, I should mention that Vladin and Gilda do have ways they can damage the boss directly in this phase without having to play tennis. Because Vladin has a gun as his basic attack. And Gilda can get like 4 air jumps.
The ultimate weapon, gun.
Ultimate weapon, gun! Oh crap, I'm out of MP, which means I can't put on my bullshit super... Well, whatever,
use
I got
focus
three
mode.
Pots. Oh right, yeah, I totally forgot about focus mode. I'm gonna use that as soon as I'm up by the head so I can do enough damage on it to actually hurt it. Okay, here we go.
He has so much health.
Boom! There we go.
Yeah, for those of you who are wondering what the game would be like if you didn't invest in one or two stats for the entire thing, this is about the rate of health drain you'd see against every boss.
It's that boss. That one boss that like was a nightmare. Like, I'm hitting every single ball. And I'm assuming they don't do damage based on my, based on my stats, they just do, like, set amount of damage, right? So, like,
at
minimum, I'm seeing 4 cycles.
Yeah, that's assuming the boss will heal itself.
That's assuming that I do it perfectly, that, like, I don't miss, like, lots of, like, balls and stuff, because, like, I'm barely at the half HP point right now, and, Oh wait, no, things it just changed up, so clearly there's something else happening now. Hey. Oh wait, no, here come the tentacles. The tentacles are back.
It's back.
Yep, welcome back to Tentacle Town.
It's the place to be if you want to be somewhere you shouldn't be.
Yeah. Ain't nobody happy in Tentacle Town.
Would you take me to Tentacle Town?
Oh wait, there's a big green. Oh, I'm supposed to. Oh, what am I doing? Oh, there's a big stupid. I've got to kill
that recharges
big,
the shield,
crystal, don't I? Because it's recharging its shield. This is a very annoying final boss.
Yeah.
Whatever. A life potted. I don't care. I got. I'm at the point where I no longer have to give a shit about life potting. Like, that ship has sailed.
I guess I at least appreciate that it was only regenerating its shield rather than its health.
Yeah, no, that's kind of like a good thing, almost. Wait, no, now it, it pulled out another one! So all of my work on his shield is for naught!
And once you get back up top, use focus mode just to burn through the shield.
I'm doing that. I'm obviously doing that.
That degree of shield recharge is ridiculous.
Yeah, no, obviously.
Okay. Oh yeah, Regulus is in the chat and says, I think it used to do health instead, which I am pretty sure it used to do health as well. Imagine
that's
that.
Horrible.
Oh crap, come on. No! Every wasted orb. I'm fairly certain that there's some weird wind effect going on in here. That's making it hard for me to go where I want to go.
I think there is, but I don't remember exactly how it works. You could always stand still for a second and see what happens.
This fight is a chaotic mess.
Yeah, stand still in it. It'll be fine.
No, I don't want to. I'm standing on my friend's frozen body.
Also, once the orbs go away and they start doing just the standalone element attacks, you might be able to reach the head with some wall jumps and such.
Yeah, no, I actually did reach it a moment ago. It's fine, but
Oh yeah, standing on Vladin's frozen body.
Oh wait, what the fuck? This fucking thing. Hey, asshole, my friend, why aren't you attacking the big stupid crystal?
I'm too important to attack.
Yeah, he seems like the guy that you know, video game character archetype 1.4, who's just like a total douche. Not like in the chugging a beer and grabbing his balls sort of way, just like in the, oh god, do I really have to put up with your shit sort of way. Oh god right. Damn it, not this, the entire shield in a second!
Yep, it's back.
Idiot.
Good work, you did the work.
Okay, thank god I was able to actually build up the focus in a reasonable amount.
Yeah,
of time.
But you did a rage slam, right?
No, just focused. It's not
okay,
like a rage
good.
Slam would do me any good right now.
That's embarrassingly true.
I really should have rage slammed it when I had the opportunity to do health damage, but you know, I didn't. Maybe these terrible little balls will do enough damage to actually kill him this round that I won't have to do a fourth cycle. That's way too much.
It's nice to dream.
Don't forget the wall jumps once those tornadoes go.
Oh my god, a stupid an attack ball spawns right after my wall jump in my path.
Rude.
Terrible.
Well, here we go. Back to the shields.
One more cycle.
Yeah, another round of this. Aren't we excited? We're having fun. This is what fun looks like now. God damn it! Fuck your shield regen.
The old version of fun. Can I downgrade to the old version of fun?
Fun
no,
Vista.
We're on new fun now. Old fun no longer exists. Come on, give me the focus mode. Yes, focus mode. Thank God.
Also, bear in mind that this is supposed to be taking place while you're escaping from a collapsing Citadel.
Yes,
because
yes,
you know, high-efficiency escape.
We even have a.
It's like the end of the Wind Waker, only more serious and edgy. Bear in mind that the end of the Wind Waker literally had you stab a guy right through his skull.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah, Wind Waker's fucking great. 94 XP!
Wind Waker also didn't make you do a very long escape sequence beforehand.
Why did it even
face.
Give you XP
That's
at
fair.
All?
Wow, okay. Alright. It's quality. It's the only part that gets destroyed the first time! I'm on it.
Oh man, Regulus is saying less serious, more edgy. Nah, this
whoa.
Is going to get less serious real quick.
Whoa.
In the best
whoa,
dumb ways.
Whoa, that face. What? Did Wyatt just get. Oh,
you just
oh
got
no, chumps. He became the bad boy. Oh, he's the angry fella. He's upset.
He's calling on the power of his demonic blood to get really, really angry.
I don't know what's happening in this picture. I have no idea.
He's punching them in the head.
In the end, my reckless behavior cost me. It was a lesson I needed to learn. Okay. I lost control back there, gave in to the rage, and as a result, everybody got saved by me. I was taken by the darkness in my soul. In those moments, I can feel Mercato's will racing through me, saying, hey, cheat on your taxes. Fortunately, I passed out before I could act on her will. Oh boy, thank goodness. Can't afford to lose control again. Not while Reyna depends on me. I must keep her alive until she is on equal footing with her sisters. I guess everybody died? Like, we saved the dog with a top hat and he's dead now? This is never a fair fight to begin with.
I don't know.
Why didn't you work harder? You could have saved Wishbone.
I may have to lie, cheat, and murder.
Sir Panfix died for our sins.
Please bring back Wishbone.
Guess that's just part of the job when you're the Hand of Death. Is that like his job title? The Hand of Death?
That's a pretty good job title.
Yay, we did it! It's the end! Yay!
That's the kind of job title that you'd like don't have to worry about salary negotiations for anymore.
Yeah, but, you know, it's a job, you know. You gotta work.
Alright, let's see if we get some scenes during the credits. I think you're due for at least one, but I don't know how far in it'll be.
I'm pretty sure I saved the entire crew. Like, that counts for something, right? Did I save the entire crew?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, we didn't miss anybody, did we? Oh my god, I thought we got them all.
Greg was saying, if you beat the game in less than 4 minutes, you get the ending where everyone wins, and I'm not quite sure if he's making a joke or not.
He might be joking, but I can't tell.
You beat the game in less than 4 minutes. Well, the speed run that I saw part of on AGDQ was 45 minutes, so,
that'd be some world record.
So that would be, that would be quite the sequence break. Clear. What's a sequence break?
It's the thing that when you're wielding three swords at once.
Oh, okay. We'll work on that. We'll work on that.
I thought that was a sequence break.
That is a sequence break. You're breaking your sequence.
Vocals for Bloodthirst. Yeah, if you go fight the one of the two bonus bosses that is like an avatar of the two gods, then you fight the dark one and they'll have like growling death metal of music.
I'll stain my hands.
I actually fought those on the other file and beat them too. I was quite happy with myself. And then I got to I did the one in the poison area by abusing poison pots.
Right.
And then I got to like another boss that was like, I can't remember his name. Was L something? L something.
Yeah, Laylodin.
Laylodin, yeah. That guy sucks, and I hate him. And I have no idea what you're supposed to do to beat him. Our home is lost. We're alive. Now what? Oh, hey, so old lady lived. And, hey, all the village elders lived. That's cool. So, okay, that's
nice.
Yep,
you saved all the town, so they do actually live.
Yay!
We're not sure about your crew, though.
Well, we owe Reyna and the others. I did all the work. Whatever, man. A home worthy
Listen,
of our
Maya new
goddess.
Listen, doesn't deserve credit.
Reyna, huh? That was pretty cool. I enjoyed this game. Except when it was bullshit. Which, you know.
Except when you were furious at it.
Yeah, it was bullshit a few times.
Yeah. It could have been worse. It could have been much better, but it could have been worse.
Oh, yeah, no. It could have been definitely worse, and it is a good game hiding in here, but it's like you said, it's a game that you absolutely need to know what you're doing ahead of time to pull off.
Solid freshman effort, hopefully.
See, Corbinu Road unlocked. Raven's Quill unlocked for new game. Seraphic Blades unlocked for new game. Valden unlocked. But not the other one? I only unlocked one of them? Huh.
That's really weird. You should have. I don't know.
You saved 100% of the civilians and crew. Did you not? Was I not paying attention? Did you not get any extra scenes?
He got one.
Okay.
It was one with the people were on top of the whales being like, oh, we need to build some new towns to...
Okay.
Oh wait, no, they're all unlocked now. They're all unlocked now. That's cool.
Okay. So you've unlocked all the playable characters. You're probably not going to do any other runs. At least not on recording.
I might screw around for a bit and then get you guys back like in a few weeks, like when I have opportunity to kill the bonus bosses on cam, because I've already killed them in the other file, and yeah, I don't think my Wyatt would fare very well against them, because his stats are kind of terrible compared to god level Wyatt's stats.
Right.
But
we
yeah,
could also, I could record my runs against the bonus bosses in my Reyna file, because I haven't done that yet.
Ooh,
so
yeah,
we could see that.
That would be worth seeing. I would
be a good way to see Reyna as well.
Mm-hmm.
And if you need a commentator on those videos, I would be happy to, since this is sort of a joint Let's Play, but really it's your Let's Play. I just sort of played a video game and you did all the work.
It's teamwork. We did the teamwork.
You did the teamwork. I sat around on my ass and every once in a while I sent you a file. Anyway.
You played video games, man. That's like half a video game LP.
Anyway, this has been Let's Play Valdis Story, starring Kalir, and also me, I guess. I do
important
hope you enjoy
co-star.
Watching it.
Da, 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 da.
Alright, ending recording. Forever. For the final time. Until we all get together and do another one of these, which you probably will.
It's over.
Whatever. Bye.